Welcome, Martin. Nice to see you.
You too.
I take it it's... I mean, what do you think when you sit out there in the wings and people say things like, you spent your time out here last time asking women, are you lonesome tonight?
I wonder who wrote your scripts for
you. Well, I worked on it. I figured I was fairly safe. But you're out this time to do Streetcar Named Desire,
yeah.
Which you did, as I read, 14 years ago. Why have you come back to it? What's the attraction?
Well, mainly because it's here.
Australia?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't, there's no way I would do it in London, but nobody's seen me do it here, and any excuse to get back here and, I mean, like that.
What was the fun last time? Because, I mean, doing the Elvis role last time was pretty harrowing, wasn't it?
Yeah. I think it was, when you get into a role like that, there are so many layers. It's like taking the skin off an onion, and you get deeper and deeper and deeper into it. And by the time we'd finished in London, and I'd had a bit of a holiday, I just wanted to do some more.
Mm-hmm. I read somewhere again that you said at the time, and I saw that Are You Lonesome Tonight, which I thought was marvellous. I thought it was just wonderful. But you said that you thought the Elvis role was the equivalent of having a nervous breakdown every night.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say that was so. I mean, I lost pounds and pounds, and it was incredibly cathartic. But like all forms of catharsis, you know, you've just washed clean. So I had the nervous breakdown on stage, and then there was the cleanliness that came afterwards, emotional and physical.
What about the perspective now? We asked you at that time about Elvis, what you thought of Elvis, but yeah. Now that there's some distance between the performance and now, I mean, do you think you understand what he was about?